With so many of us stuck at home right now, it's really common for people to be struggling with putting on more weight than they want. So today I want to give you some strategies you can take to make sure you don't gain too much weight when you're quarantined at home. So when we are stuck at home, there's two main reasons why all of a sudden we'd start gaining more weight. One would be you're probably eating more than you were before, and two, you're getting less activity, both through exercise and probably your everyday life. But I think the bigger struggle for most people here is the mindless eating that can happen when you're just sitting around your house. There's a few main reasons why this would happen, one being boredom, another being stress, and then using food as a coping mechanism. When we use food to cope, it's because something is making us feel bad and we don't like the way that feels, so we want to do something to make ourselves feel better in the moment. And while turning to food will help in the moment, it's only going to make you feel worse in the long run, and it can become a vicious cycle. So the first thing we need to do to help is acknowledge why this is happening, because if you don't even know why, it's pretty hard to address it. And one of my favorite tips to help with mindless eating or stress eating and things like that, and that's to talk to yourself out loud and ask yourself, am I eating because I'm hungry or because I'm bored or because I'm stressed or whatever it may be? Or one of my personal favorite tactics that helps me with everything in life is to always ask myself, will I regret doing this action? If the answer is yes, then I won't do it because I hate living with regret. So making sure you're being honest with yourself about it can be really helpful. Now you may think the whole talking to yourself out loud thing is kind of nuts. Like it makes you sound like a crazy person, right? But I'm telling you, it's powerful and it works and it has to be out loud. In fact, this is a strategy I give to a lot of clients who struggle with emotional eating, and it has helped a lot of people. And the reason it works is because when you're in your head, when you're just thinking to yourself, it's all emotion. When you say it out loud, it becomes logic. It gets much more real. So not only does this help you in the moment, but it also is a great help in understanding why you're doing what you're doing, and that makes it much easier to get in front of in the future. And perhaps what's even more important is if you do have a binging episode, we're all human, we're all gonna make some mistakes sometimes, but you have to forgive yourself and move on and do not, under any circumstance, beat yourself up. This is the worst thing you can possibly do because beating yourself up will cause way more damage than any amount of overeating you can possibly do. Because think about it, what really happens when you beat yourself up? It's not like you go, okay, I took a good looking and I'm ready to get back on track now. No, you typically just feel worse and it ends up spiraling into this big thing. And now all of a sudden you're feeling like crap and you're still overeating and you're doing it for days, weeks, months, hell, possibly even years. So instead, forgive yourself, be kind to yourself and just move on. Take the lessons from it. There's always a lesson. There's always something you can reflect on and go, okay, what happened here? Why did I do this? And what led me to this? What were some of my triggers? And then realize there's nothing you can do about the past, but there's always something you can do about now and what you do moving forward. Now, another tip you can use during this time is to make sure you create structure and routine. A big reason why it's easier to stay on track during everyday life is because we do typically have this structured routine that we use and we have a set schedule. You go to work at a certain time, you have lunch at a certain time, you go to the gym at a certain time, you have certain times of the day and everything just flows the same and it keeps you in routine. In fact, this is a big reason why a lot of people struggle on the weekends in general, because you get out of that routine and you don't have the normal structure. So now that you're home all the time and you don't have a normal routine, it can be easy for things to start slipping. So I personally think it's a good idea to try to keep the same schedule you had as much as possible, especially if you're working from home, still keep doing things at the same times you used to do. For instance, I'm going to USF right now and taking a class called Science of Weight Management under Dr. Bill Campbell, and we would meet Mondays and Wednesdays at 2:00. Now everything's online with the social distancing, and I can watch these videos that he has, the presentations and stuff, anytime I want, but I still set my schedule to do the schoolwork at 2:00 on Mondays and Wednesdays to keep that schedule. I normally work out around 2 to 3 o'clock. Now that I'm working out from home, I'm doing that still between about 2 and 3 o'clock and keeping that routine. So the more you keep your routine the same, the more likely it is for you to keep yourself from getting off and finding yourself going to the fridge all the time. Another strategy you can take is to make sure you're planning ahead as much as possible and still doing things like meal prep and having certain times of the day that you eat. In fact, a strategy that helps a lot of people just in general anyways is to remove snacking from your meals, or even if you do snack, you still have certain times of the day and you have it mapped out ahead of time. So when you commit to eating these meals or these snacks or whatever you're gonna do and just stick to that plan, it keeps you from going off and constantly going to the cabinet to get more food. Because it's the random snacking when you're not normally eating that is probably causing most of the overeating. But perhaps one of the best things you can do right now during this time is just take time to work on things that you wanted to work on anyways, now that you have a little bit more time on your hands. And this can not only help keep you busy and distracted, but it can be a big help for your fitness goals as you move forward too. Now there's some strategies we can take and there's some goals we can create here, but hear me out, this is gonna look different on everyone. But this could be a good time to go into a cut if it's something that you were thinking of anyway and you're in a good spot metabolically to begin with. Because think about it, you have total control over your food now. There's no going out to restaurants, there's no going to get-togethers and parties and things that would be more difficult to keep on plan. And while exercise is a little more limited, there's always things you can do at home, and you can still go out for walks as long as you're staying 6 feet away from people. And you can get activity in because you probably have more time anyway. And some of my clients who decided to do this are seeing fantastic results because they have so much more control than they used to. And really, just mentally, one of the biggest things that people typically struggle with is just life stress in general. And obviously, stress is pretty high right now, and it can make you feel like you have no control. And honestly, most of the time when we are getting stressed from life, it is things that we have no control over. And this makes you feel helpless. But nutrition is the one thing that you have full control over at all times, no matter what. Yes, there's times that it's more difficult and there's some things, especially emotionally, that can be a challenge, but you still do have that control. And sometimes just feeling like you have control over something by controlling your nutrition, you're gonna build some wins. It's gonna help you build momentum in other areas because it feels good to do the things you know you should even when you don't feel like it. So there's some real value in feeling like, hey, I have control here, and it carries over. But that's not for everyone. We're all different. We can't put everyone into a box. And for some people, trying to cut right now or trying to be hyper-focused on nutrition would be a terrible idea because it would lead them to feeling like they're a failure. They're gonna go into the all or nothing approach and start binging because they just feel like they just cannot do it. So what's the point? So especially if this is something that you tend to struggle with in general, this can be a great time now to focus on being more flexible with your food choices, being more flexible with how you approach everything, but not falling into, well, what's the point in going nuts, and keeping somewhat of a control, but not too much. So maybe doing something like having a calorie target and a protein target, but not caring how you interchange your carbs or fats. Or maybe you just have a rough calorie target, even a range within a couple hundred, and you just say, okay, I'm just gonna try to get a good protein source with each meal. Or hell, maybe you just do calories and you don't worry about it at this point. Sometimes food options are a little limited right now with the grocery stores being pretty empty. But the point is, it can be really valuable for a lot of people to see, hey, I don't have to be perfect and I can still keep things in check. And there's something very valuable about not going backwards just because you're not going forwards. In fact, for some people who typically do a lot of tracking, but would like to get to a point where they can eat more intuitively and not feel like they need to track so much, this could be a good opportunity to start practicing that. Try to be more intuitive, don't track, kind of keep your meals roughly the same and loosen up on the tracking and just see how things go and practice these skills that you want to carry over once this is all over with. So again, this just shows we cannot put everyone into a box. I see so many people posting about like, okay, this is a time when you should do this and or you should do that. And they're just saying like everyone should do this. No, we're all different. We all have different tendencies and preferences and different goals. And we need to make sure we're doing something that works well for us, but dig deep and really think about what you truly need and can benefit out of this time. It's a tough time we're in right now. It is. I'm not making light of this. It's very difficult. But we can use this time to better ourselves. And I honestly don't care if this sounds corny. I really truly believe that adversity and struggles are the very things that make us better, that make us stronger. This is how we grow. But only if we use the opportunity to tackle it and improve and not let it beat us down. Because you can take two people with the exact same circumstances, the total same scenarios, and one person will get through this period and they will come out the other side and they will improve and grow, and the other person will get crushed and blame the circumstances. I really believe this is a wake-up call for all of us. I feel like we had gotten pretty soft as humans, and going through something really challenging like this, this may be, hopefully will be, the hardest thing any of us go through. And by getting through this, everything that we thought was a challenge before will now not seem so bad. It'll be easier to handle adversity because of going through this period. And that's why this makes you stronger. Because the thing to keep in mind here is, whether you like it or not, we are going through this. There is no escaping it. We have to go through this. So you might as well get stronger from it. At the end of the day, this is going to change you in one way. It's either going to make you stronger or it's going to make you weaker. And how you choose to respond to it is what determines which one of those things are going to happen. So accept reality for what it is. I know the reality sucks, but if you fight it, it's only going to bring you down. Focus on controlling what you can control and make yourself proud. Now do this next. Check out this top video I have on the screen for some extra motivation to get through this mess and live a happier, healthier life. I can pretty much promise you it's gonna open your eyes to some of the things that you were doing without even knowing it to sabotage your efforts and your happiness. And I'll see you next time.